Upon import of the results, the whole genome MLST quality assessment window opens. One can also open the quality assessment window with a fourth button. The left upper part shows an overview of the selected entries and their detailed analysis results. The color code gives an indication of the quality of the data. Double-clicking on an entry reveals more detail on the statistics, the assembly-free allele calling, and the assembly-based allele calling. Values that do not meet the quality standards show up on a red background. The genome panel visualizes the present features in an interactive way. The tracks panel gives an overview of the information that can be plotted on the circular graph. You can zoom in on the genome viewer up to a nucleotide level. You can display the tracks in color using this button. Clicking on a track will highlight it in the tracks panel and vice versa. Details of the loci and the detected alleles are shown in the alleles panel. A zooming area can be specified with graph set view range to cover a range of bases, hold down the Shift key while selecting a position with the mouse. Clicking on a locus in the Alleles panel will update the cursor selection on the map. The loci are plotted as colored arrows on the map, indicating the locus number and the allele sequence number between brackets. Our sequence identity matches range over white, yellow, orange to red. A question mark in the first column of the allele panel indicates that this allele could be, but has not yet been submitted to the curator database. For instance, for this assembly-based allele detected, we can see the assembly-free and assembly-based sequence identity, their start and stop position, and the contig information. Details on the alignment and the similarity are shown in the Details panel. This set of filter buttons facilitates viewing specific subsets of loci. The first button filters out alleles that closely resemble one of the approved alleles or are eligible for submission. I can sort them according to assembly-based sequence identity. I select the ones of interest, and I use this button to upload them to the curated allele nomenclature server. Mind that an automated submission of new alleles can be automated from the settings dialog box. Pressing this last button will open the alignment window with the query allele and all confirmed allele sequences for that specific locus. This window is opened as temporary analysis.